I noticed that he was about a minute over. So, unfortunately, we're going to have to dock his pay. We need a couple minutes to set some stuff up here, but I was just thinking that if we wanted, we could set up a Kickstarter project. That would be one of the most pointless and expensive Kickstarter projects in the history of Kickstarter. Just the conference room? It's not a bad idea. But yeah, if we're going to ball pit the conference room, we're going to ball pit it all the way. We'll create some sort of, diaphragm on the door so that you can just sort of... It's a sex party. Most awkward, uncomfortable sex party ever. Also, probably at the end of the cruise, there would be a lot of dice on the floor. You would never find them again. So our next act is the Double Clicks. I met these guys through Paul and Storm and their ever-expanding Woodstock empire. They write funny songs that are also pretty songs. You know, I asked them, is there anything special you'd like me to say about you when I introduce you? And they said, well, let's see. We're a band, and we play music, and we both have glasses. So with that in mind, please welcome the Double Clicks.
To be here. There are not enough words of thanks that we could say to Paul and Jonathan and Storm and all of the staff and volunteers that make this happen. We knew it was going to be awesome, but I can honestly say we had no idea. I'm going to play a song now. Invite me to the bar with your friends. like it when I'm with you. I can't believe you thought it was embarrassing just because I call you kitten. I thought you liked that name. I thought it was a symbol of us being comfortable with each other and how much we love each other and care about each other and trust each other, but I guess not. So why don't you go on to the bar with your friends, watch your sports ball, and drink your beers, or whatever. And when you're good and done, you can come over to my house and I'll have dinner waiting for you because I love you. And that'll be fine. I guess that's okay. If that's what you really want, that's great. I just thought you wanted me to be happy. I thought you loved me. We are the Double Clicks. My name is Angela, and my lovely sister Aubrey is here on the cello. We are going to play X number of songs tonight, today. And this next one is about an argument I have with my friends, and there's a sing-along chorus, so we put it second in the show. Okay. I told myself I wasn't gonna ad-lib, and that's why, you guys. Alright, here we go. Would you rather have flight or invisibility? Or would you rather have the power to control the creatures of the sea? Would you rather be able to rapidly change your size? Or would you rather be able to squirt blood out of your eyes? That would be the worst superpower ever. The worst superpower ever. That would be the worst superpower ever. Would you rather stop time or never need to breathe? Or would you rather have your one weakness be a really common thing? What if you were lactose intolerant but could make things taste like cheese? Or if you had the power to induce a slight fatigue? Everybody, that would be the worst superpower ever. The worst superpower ever. That would be the worst superpower ever. Would you rather have an extra hand or run real fast and far? Or would you rather be a really rich dude with a super awesome car? Would you rather be able to create an invisible chair?
Yes.
Or have the ability to always predict what someone else will wear? That would be the worst superpower ever. The worst superpower ever. That would be the worst superpower ever.
Him a very good boyfriend.
saw his furrowed brow. I knew the ideal man had come and found me somehow. I mean, what else could I think when he looked me in the eye and told me prune juice is a warrior's drink? I fell in love with a wharf impersonator, from his forehead to his batleth and his badge communicator. I thought my search for love was at an end, but being strong and angry did not make him a very good boyfriend. Despite that thing that just happened, I might let my sister sing a song right now. Are you guys okay with that? Aubrey wrote this song. It's a beautiful lullaby. She brought it to me and she said, this is a lullaby, and played it. And I said, that is beautiful and calm and peaceful and surely will help people sleep. And I can fix it. And that...
Okay, I'm gonna sing it. Are you ready?
I am. The song is called A Lullaby for Mr. Bear.
So sing a little.
Interesting fact, we do have a kids' album, but on that song, Aubrey just cut me out of it completely. Replaced me with a cello solo, of course. This next song is very special. I understand that yesterday was Melanie's birthday. Melanie, are you around? Somebody? Yeah,
hi, Melanie!
Melanie's birthday was yesterday, everybody, but also today, we decided. So you should buy her a piña colada. I understand she likes those. Not so much getting caught in the rain, not her thing. Sorry. This is a birthday song we wrote. There is a sing-along part, which we'll sing it for you so you'll know what it is. Are you guys ready to sing along, I should ask? I thought so. All right, here we go. Today's Melanie's birthday, so it is time to sing and hope she does not disappear with the help of a magic ring. She's a really hoopy fruit and a super shiny nerd, so let's not split the party as we all join in the words. You're getting older, live long and prosper. When it counts, may you roll high. Happy birthday to you, Melanie. You're getting older. Are you guys ready? One, two, three. You're getting older. Live long and prosper. When it counts, may you roll high. Happy birthday to you, Melanie. Have a fracking awesome time. So say. Pina coladas, I'm doing this. I really was leaving it up to you guys to make a Mike Furman joke. Oh, you did, I just didn't hear you. Okay, good work, guys. This next song...
Yeah, good, am I in tune?
I'm ready. This next song is about love and literature. When I was first learning of love as a teenager, one source gave me all my ideas and theories. Jane Austen's masterpiece work, Pride and Prejudice, are actually the 1995 BBC miniseries. Oh, that Mr. Darcy, so gruff and so distant, with a sensitive spirit just waiting to shine. There's a reason for the cliche that women love germs. It just seems like such a good idea at the time. Oh, 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 Mr. Darcy, oh, 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 Colin Firth, you're tall, dark, and handsome, charming and wonderful. I traveled to Europe to study and learn and go clubbing and drink. There was a cute boy in my history of lessons who hailed from near London and mostly ignored me. So of course I fell for him and his charming voice. His detachment and rudeness got me in a snap. He finally noticed me at the end of semester, took me on one date and treated me like crap. Oh, 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 Mr. Darcy, oh, 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 Colin Firth, you wily old bastard, you wonderful specimen, you've messed up the hearts of young girls round the earth. If you gentleman hailing from England, don't be so impressed. Hold on to your heart. Just because someone has a British accent does not mean they're witty or decent or smart. If a boy treats you with tasteful indifference, if he is handsome but bristly and cold, don't be intrigued just because he's ignoring you. Not every asshole has a heart of gold. Like, not even, like, you are the best audience, literally, in the entire world. Seriously. We're never getting off the stage. I'm just gonna rock back and forth. This next song, you guys, I'm gonna be honest, it is brand friggin' new. So I'm gonna tune. It's not even a joke, it's just Roderick. Aubrey asked me if I could do the cool thing that Roderick was doing when he was tuning before, and I asked her if she could do that cool thing Zoe Keating did with her cello. One more sip of water. New song, here we go, you guys.
To go away. I know you
don't want us to really play Skinner. The request is at this point absurd. Even if your bros are patting your back, you're still the guy who yelled free bird.
Why did you yell
free bird? You are the guy who yelled free bird. Free bird. Nobody wants to hear free bird. You don't understand. You see, we're a band, and we hear that same joke every day. Did you notice your wife has let go of your hand, and your friends are all edging away? I'm not saying it's fair, but everyone's thinking you're a prick, or a jerk, or a turd. Even if you or I leave here tomorrow, you'll be the guy who yelled free bird.
Why did you
free bird? You are the guy who yelled free bird. Free bird. Nobody wants to hear free bird. What? Oh, okay. Google Plus? I don't under- Okay, we'll talk later. This next song, you guys, is about believing in yourself. You're not the right shape, and you're not the right size. You don't get along with others, but you need to realize that the actors in the movies are not what you're supposed to be. You are good the way you are, 'cause you are you, that's best you see. We've all been looking for role models and turned our eyes to Hollywood, but that's not where to find them. Look to yourself, yes, that is good, it's okay. Velociraptor, don't be sad. Velociraptor, 'cause you're the size of a turkey, not a lion. Can't turn a knob and don't have friends upon whom you can rely. The movies have created an unattainable expectation. The raptors in those films were a fictional creation. Don't judge yourself too hard, Velociraptor. You are good the way you are, Velociraptor. Myself in the position where we have time to do another song that's not on our set list. Yeah. Sure. Yep. Hilarious. I think we're gonna do a song because this seems to be a theme for this cruise. Called Mr. Suckface. No, this is a song about a little over a year ago, I quit my job to become a nerd folk star. And it was a really funny thing to see everybody's face when I did that. And this song was actually written for a song, Foo. Last year we got a lot of celebrity challenges. This was Mike Furman's challenge, was to write a song about the last day of work. And that is this song.
Foo.
For 3 years you woke up and you went to a job that was boring and hard and lame. Your folks don't explain to their friends what you do, 'cause it's dull and they feel ashamed. But you finally gave your notice, and it's come to your very last day. You've only got 8 more hours to go, and then you can get away. It's the final countdown. You had nightmares about being trapped in that office, that room, in that job, in that chair. And you daydreamed about getting hit by a bus or falling down a set of stairs. But that nightmare is finally ending. There's an end to your pleas and sighs, and your colleagues are looking at you with their sad puppy, "Please bring me with you" eyes. Just a series of ones and zeros in between coffee breaks. You hoped you'd at least done the company proud in your 815 days. But the value's as clear as the icing that spells the wrong name on your goodbye cake. It's the doing an extreme disservice to everyone on the boat if we did not introduce this next performer to join us on stage. I can't say that much more. Ladies and gentlemen, Zoe Keating. I am the...
We're friends.
The battle was intense. But we're friends now. All of the violins are dead. So this is our second to last song. This song is about the Mars Science Laboratory, Mars Curiosity. Did you guys watch the night that it landed on Mars? It was a beautiful moment with all of the science and the amazing things that happened. It was an amazing night to be a human being on Twitter. What with all of the space and the haircuts and so on. This song is about curiosity and sort of all of the feels that we get when we think about it.
Why we need an extra cello.
We're gonna need that later, but it'll be good. All right.
Familiar today, the folks who brought me up.
up for this have such high expectations. And though they shouldn't, they have dared to dream that I can change it all. Thousands watch as I turn on my camera and do my first job. I feel so important and so very small. All I can think is of the ways I'll disappoint them. I've got the tools, I've got the team, but I'm not ready for my close side. Everybody trusts me more than I do, and I still don't feel like I've even grown up, but I am faking it. I'm just pretending I can do this. I am faking it. I am faking it on Mars. Disappears, and out here it is cold and it is lonely, and I am far from home. What would Hubble say if she were only here? And the worst part is not knowing what will greet me. I represent my planet, but I'm really not prepared. I hope that I have time to ask for all the help I need, and I hope if I find aliens, I won't act too scared.
The screen. There it goes. The screen. What? So, we decided to do a lot of new things for this cruise. And one of Aubrey literally does not know why you're laughing, and that is really funny. I'm not gonna tell her either. I may have sabotaged myself with that. Okay. And one of them is, we have this amazing music video for this song that we wrote, and we're gonna play along with it. which it's a great idea and is gonna go really well. For this next song, we also need to introduce another performer because We have to have 100% female performer integration into our set. Molly Lewis, everybody. What's going on out here? Oh, you know, just chilling. There's a really big audience.
I know. I think I speak for the audience when I say that the last one gave us all the feels.
Yeah. Right? You didn't have stereo cellos on you. That was like, oh my god. All right, well, Molly, we have toured with Molly quite a bit, and she was kind enough to learn some vocals for this song.
Do you want to thank anybody? This is our last song.
Oh yeah, this is our last song. Thank you guys so much for being wonderful, and
amazing.
This is wholly amazing. W-H-O-L-L-Y, Batman. Batman. Yeah.
Holy adjectives, Ben.
I think that's it. This is a song about love and so on. You're sure not tall, and you're not all that attractive, 'cause you're a level 8 dwarf and you drink too much ale. You drink way too much ale. But you've got a nice axe and you know how to use it. It's +2 against zombies. And the moment you set foot in this campaign, you set a magic missile on my heart and charm person on my brain. Dungeons and Dragons, yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons with you. Yes, I do, yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons. But I wanna get you out of this fantasy world and into my fantasy, and out of this basement and into the sun. Dungeons and Dragons, one time you saved me by setting an oncoming horde of golems on fire. And one time you saved me from the mouth of a volcano, 'cause you can levitate, which was a very clever spell choice. And I think the other players might be starting to suspect, 'cause you're always saving me when shit turns to heck. But this is so much more than Dungeons and Dragons. Yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons with you. Yes, I do. Yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons. But I wanna get you out of this fantasy world and into my fantasy, where you could be my boyfriend and we could go out to dinner. Dungeons and Dragons. We finish this battle and we slay the dragon and look around her lair for loot, like golden magic items. I look around this room, all these fucking nerds and all their fucking books and their fucking dice, and they're primarily Windows-based computers and their Doritos and Mountain Dew. Everything here is disgusting but you. And Dungeons and Dragons, yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons with you. Yes, I do, yes, I like playing Dungeons and Dragons. But I wanna get you out of this fantasy world and into my fantasy and into my bed, where we could have sex. Dungeons and Dragons.
Thank you.
Double clicks, ladies and gentlemen. 15-minute intermission.